everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about study of TRIAC and AC phase control, and its order code is 46521. So in this video we are going to discuss about its working. Now let's see the components that are present on the kit. So this is the L and N port. Here we will connect the main supply. Then this is the load section. Here we are using load of 40 watt bulb. Then there is a hole present on the kit so that we can observe the glowing and dimness of the bulb or the load. Then this is the TRIAC, then there are some resistance, then this is the transistor first, then this is the transistor second, this is the potentiometer of 4K7, and we can vary the potentiometer value by using this port. Then this is the second potentiometer of 470K, and we can also vary this by using this port. Then there is a diac present, then there are some other resistance and capacitors present. Now let's perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study the TRIAC characteristics and its operation. So for that we have to do the connections first. So we can check the resistance value of TRIAC. So for that we will use a multimeter and we will keep it at resistance, and now we will connect it between MT2 and MT1 like this. So this is the high resistance open circuit value. Then we can get the same reading by connecting MT2 and gate. So this is also the open circuit high resistance value. Then we can check the resistance value between MT1 and gate. So it is the low resistance value and it is around 160 ohm. So that is how we can measure the resistance. Now we will perform the experiment. So for that we will do the connections. So now firstly we have to connect the S1 with the MT2 and MT1 with the negative of 0.5. Then we will connect multimeter around G1 and G. So we will keep the multimeter at ammeter range. So for that we will keep it at milliampere range, and now we will connect it between G1 and G. So the positive will be connected to the G1 and the negative will be connected to G. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will connect the main supply to the L and N port like this. And now we will connect the DC power supply. So here we are using DC power supply range from 0 to 30 volt. So now we will connect it so the positive will be connected to the positive and the negative will be connected to the negative, and the positive and negative ports are indicated on the kit. So that is how we will connect the DC supply and the main supply. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the DC power supply, and now we will give some voltage to the kit. So after giving some voltage approximately 2 volt, then you can see the bulb is glowing. And when you increase the voltage, you can observe that the bulb will glow more. And we can also see graph on the DSO. So here you can see that as I have increased the voltage to 4 volt, the bulb glow more. So at 2 volt, the brightness of the bulb is dim, and now at 4 volt, the brightness is increased. Now we will observe the waveform on the DSO. So now, firstly we will switch on the DSO. And keep it at channel 1 and connect the probe at channel 1. Now we will connect the DSO across the load. So we will connect the negative of the DSO to the negative of the DC port, and now we will connect the positive to the L. And here you can see that this is the waveform which we get on the DSO. And now we will see the waveform across MT2. So here you can see that on the DSO, the waveform gets shifted on the negative side. So this is the waveform which we get at MT2 port. And you can see the current reading at the multimeter. So when the DC supply is 4 volt, the current reading which we get is approx 4 milliampere. Now we will reverse the polarity of the DC supply. So for that, we will connect the positive to the negative port and the negative to the positive port like this. So we have changed the polarities of the DC supply. So now we will give some DC voltage to the kit. So here you can see that at 2 volt the bulb glows, and now the current reading which we get is in negative. And now we will observe the waveform on the DSO. So for that we have to do the connections as we have done previously. So we will connect the negative to the negative, and now we will connect the positive at the MT2. So here on the DSO you can see the waveform. So this is the waveform which we get. So we can give more voltage at the DC supply port. So if we increase the voltage, then the brightness of the bulb increases. So here you can see that the brightness of the bulb increased as I increase the DC power supply. So that is how we can perform this experiment. Now we will perform another experiment, that is to study gate control of TRIAC with NPN transistor. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect S1 with the MT2 like this. Then we will connect MT1 with the positive port like this. Then we will connect the P port with the positive port like this. Then we will connect the Q port with the negative DC port like this. So here we will use NPN transistor. So the NPN transistor we are using is T1, that is BC107B. Now we will connect the triac of gate to the G2, and now we will connect the multimeter across. Port B. So now we will connect the positive of the multimeter with the B and the negative of the multimeter to the B port of the transistor. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will connect the main supply to the L and N port, and now we will connect the DC supply across the DC supply port. So the positive will be connected to the positive and the negative will be connected to the negative port like this. Now we have to give some DC voltage. So for that we will now increase the DC power supply voltage. So I am keeping it at approx 3 volt, and now firstly we have to keep this potentiometer at fully anti-clockwise direction, and now we have to slowly rotate this potentiometer port clockwise. So here you can see that the bulb starts glowing and we are getting current reading at the multimeter. So it is approx 0.038 milliampere. At the starting it is 0, but now when we rotate the potentiometer port at clockwise direction we can get the current reading. So that is how we can take the observations. So as we increase the potentiometer value, the value of current increases, and as we increase the voltage we can see the different values. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will perform another experiment, that is to study gate control of triac with PNP transistor. So just we have to do some changes in this connections. So now we will use the transistor second, that is the PNP transistor. So we will shift the connection of transistor first to transistor 2. So now we will connect the triac gate at G3 and the DC supply at the transistor 2 port, and now we will connect the multimeter across B and B2. So that is how the connection is done. So now we will give some DC power supply, but first we have to keep in mind that the potentiometer port should be at anti-clockwise direction. Now we will give some DC voltage. So here I am giving approximately 3 volt. So here you can see that the bulb starts glowing. And now when we rotate the potentiometer at clockwise direction, we can see that the bulb brightness get dim. So here you can see that the bulb gets off when we rotate the potentiometer at clockwise direction. So when we again rotate it at anti-clockwise direction, so we can see that the bulb gets on. So at 2 volt DC supply, the reading which we get at multimeter is minus 0.028 milliampere, and now when we rotate the potentiometer port at clockwise direction, we can see that the current reading gets reduced, and that's why the bulb gets off. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we will perform another experiment, that is to study phase control with TRIAC using DIAC as pulse generator for gate trigger. So for that we have to do the connections first. So now we will do the connections. So firstly we will connect S1 with the MT2, then we will connect gate of the TRIAC to the L port of the DIAC, and now we will connect the C port with the D port, and now we will connect the other port of the D port to the MT1, and now we will connect B port with the A port, and now we will connect S port with the MT2 port. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will connect the main supply to the L and N port. So now after the connection is done, now we will switch on the DSO. And now we will rotate the second potentiometer, that is the 470K potentiometer R2. Now we will rotate it in clockwise direction. Firstly we have to keep it at anti-clockwise direction like this, and now we will rotate it clockwise. So here you can see that the bulb starts glowing, and now we can see the waveform on the DSO. So we have to connect the DSO across gate of TRIAC and MT1. So this is the waveform which we get on the DSO. So you can observe the waveform on the DSO. And if we rotate the potentiometer anti-clockwise, so you can see that the waveform gets disappear or. And now when we rotate the potentiometer at fully clockwise direction, this is the waveform which we get on the DSO. So that is how the experiment is performed. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.